in an atmosphere of elegance and refinement. Object, matrimony. Unfortunately, I won't be able to offer my usual lightning service to today, as I have a previous appointment in Yonkers, New York, arranging the second marriage of Mr. Horace Vandergill, the well-known half-millionaire. But as my late husband, Ephraim Levi, used to say, it means you've got at least 60,000 cash. But of course, I will do my best to have you carried across someone's threshold before the week is out. Now, I might also mention, I'm available for financial consultation, short distance calling, instruction in the guitar and mandolin, and varicose veins reduced.
Oh, Aunt Dolly. She's the one the spinsters recommend. Just name the kind of man your sister wasn't just matching up. Don't forget to bring your maiden aunt and she'll match him up.
Oh, Aunt Dolly.
Mrs. Levi.
Oh, Mr. Pepper, the artist. You know, I'm something of an artist myself. I do those silhouettes with scissors and black paper. Oh, where is it? Here's one of Ada Rayham looking the other way. I have to do them like that because I'm no good at noses.
Mrs. Levi, the train for Yonkers leaves in 5 minutes. If we don't get there on time,
oh, we will, Mr. Pepper. And not only will Horace Vanderfelder give you permission to marry his niece, Ermengarde, but he will also be there to dance at your wedding. Not alone, either, because I happen to be engaged in finding him a suitable second wife himself. What he really wants is someone steady to clean the house. As my late husband, Ephraim Levi, used to say, marriage is a bribe to make a housekeeper think she's a householder.
I know all about it, Mrs. Levi. Well, half of New York says he's going to propose to Mrs. Irene Malloy this very afternoon.
Which is exactly why I'm on my way to Yonkers this morning, Mr. Pepper, and can take on your case. Knock off four lovebirds with one stone, or whatever I see, I'll throw. Well, 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 what do you think of that? I have nothing here to pay my train fare with. Only large bills, fives, sevens.
I have some change here somewhere. I only hope this isn't a wild goose chase, Mrs. Levi.
And speaking of poultry, I am also available for fresh Jersey eggs, surgical corsets reboned, ears pierced, pierced ears replugged.
Mrs.
And
Levi!
Just name the kind of man your sister wants and she'll snatch him up. Don't forget to bring your maiden aunt and she'll match him up. Call on Dolly.
It takes a woman all powdered in pink to joyously clean out the train in the sink. And it takes an angel with long golden lashes and soft-dressed in fingers for dumping the ashes.
Yes, it takes a woman, a dainty woman, a sweetheart, a mistress, a wife. Oh, yes, it takes a woman, a fragile woman, to bring you the sweet things in life.
For washing and blueing and shoeing the mare. And it takes a female for setting the table and cleaning the Guernsey and cleaning the stable.
Yes, it takes a woman, a dainty woman, a sweetheart, a mistress, a wife. Oh, yes, it takes a woman, a fragile woman, to bring you the sweet things in life.
And so she'll work on to infinity. Three cheers for femininity.
Rah, rah, rah! Rah, rah, rah! F-E-M-I-T-Y! Get out of here!
And in the winter, she'll shock the ice and lovingly set out traveling of mice. She's a joy and treasure for practically speaking. To whom can you turn when the plumbing is leaking?
To that dainty woman, that fragile woman, that sweetheart, that mistress, that wife. Oh yes, it takes a woman,
a husky woman,
to bring you the sweet things in life. Oh yes,